you listen to first?
What you listen to? Young Jeezy.
Young Jeezy?
Yeah.
All right, I'm about to wait for it. All right, go ahead.
Right after watching some of the video, how much had to do with the Celtics' switches and defense and the fact you guys just didn't hit shots?
No, they just framed the play better than us in game one. So we're about to redeem ourselves now.
Historically, you bounced back strong in games two. You did it obviously against the Pacers. I mean, is it just taking it up another gear?
No, it's not about the gear. It has to be up no matter what. It's the postseason. I don't know. You know, history speaks for itself, but at the end of the day, we still got to come out and play. The game is won in between the lines and not, you know, written on the line. So, you know, we have to go on for it.
LeBron, as you felt out game one, is it important for game two you guys get off to a fast start?
Well, I mean, that's been important for us all year. You know, we got off to a slow start in the first quarter, the third quarter. That's resulted in a lot of losses for us this year, no matter if it's the regular season or the postseason. So, you know, we look to try to get off to a good start tonight.
Do you drive like confidence on the team bouncing back in the two prior series?
History is history. I'm going to live in the moment. You can't rely on what you did in previous series. You got to rely on, you know, your instincts. You got to rely on, you know, the coaching staff and what they put together as far as the game plan. And then you go out and execute. So, just because you did something in one series or the previous series, don't mean you can, you know, result back to that. You have to be ready for that next game.
How important was George Hill in the last round? How critical is he tonight and going forward?
Well, he's been a big piece since we got him in trade. He's played well for us. We've succeeded. And I think at the end of the day, it's always tough on someone to get someone at the trade deadline. You know, try to learn the system right away and also learn the system and be a part of a system where you are looking to win every game. You know, you can't really slow track. You got to try to fast track the process. So, you know, but he's a veteran. He's played on championship teams before. We're one of the teams that's trying to, you know, compete for a championship as well. So, right.
Coming out here early like you did, was that more about maintaining routine or doing what other takes to try to change things up?
Nah, I was out there.
You worked so much on your shot, the three ball, is have you found anything that might be lacking?
I just missed last game. I'm not concerned about it. Take the same once tonight.
LeBron, there's talk.
Great battles with a lot of teams, a lot of franchises, a lot of history. Talk about a little bit about the battles with the Celtics and the rebuilds they've had and sort of going at different teams, and here we are again.
You can say the same for me. I've been a part of different teams as well. With all my battles I've had with the Houston since 07 or 08, I've had different teams as well. So that's how the league goes. You play with different guys, teams rebuild. I've been fortunate enough to play with some really good teams to be able to compete versus a historical franchise like here in the Celtics. So, that's the nature of the sport.
Has there anything been striking about the Celtics since maybe 2003, literally since the Bengals traded?
Striking is that they've always tried to put themselves in a position to win a championship, and that's what it's about here. I mean, just look up in the rafters. Nothing has changed, even though if they had some losing seasons, they've always had the mindset of how they can figure out to get back to a championship level. So, you know, if you know the history of the league, when the Celtics, the Lakers, and the Knicks are really good, and it's the best for the league. So, those are the franchises that have been trying to do it, you know, since the beginning of time.
LeBron, there's speculation that Tristan might move back in the starting lineup tonight. How will that affect what you guys do, how you play?
It doesn't matter who's in the starting lineup. We have to play, you know, Cavs basketball. So, you know, I haven't heard that, but I'm not speculating about it. Anyway, so, whoever's in the lineup tonight, we'll be ready to go.
Nick Gilbert's supposed to be on the tonight at the lottery.
Situation with someone going through something that's as life-threatening as it is, and to be able to come to some of the home games and like you said, be at the lottery tonight, representing our franchise, you know, it's a blessing.
Is that a yes?